Aminoglycosides are the most commonly used antibiotic worldwide due to their effectiveness, low cost, and safety for use in pregnant women and newborns. Unfortunately, aminoglycosides are also ototoxic, meaning that they cause damage to the ear by directly targeting the sensory hair cells necessary for hearing. The death of these hair cells causes hearing loss and is currently permanent and irreversible. A team of Stanford researchers aims to improve a widely used drug treatment so that sick patients will no longer have to make this decision and suffer these life-altering side effects.
I'm a pediatric otolaryngologist, which means that I see patients, kids, with ear problems. One particular problem that I'm interested in is patients with hearing loss.
So I have been a cell physiologist, so I study the sensory cells, which are called hair cells. And the lab has focused on the process of sound being converted into a signal recognized by the brain. And they're called hair cells because they have these little cilia that stick out the top. And when sound comes in, they vibrate. And when they vibrate, this opens a mechanically gated channel. And aminoglycosides had been commonly used in studying the biophysics of the channel because they block the channel. In doing those experiments, what we found was that the aminoglycosides don't just block the channel, but they actually go through the channel. So it looks like a cork in the bottle kind of thing, but it's not. It actually goes all the way through. But they don't come back out very easily. And so they go in and they accumulate at high levels in the sensory cell. And we postulated that this was how they were killing the cell.
We were able to come up with a synthetic pathway, chemical synthetic pathway, that basically allowed us to convert a toxic aminoglycoside antibiotic to a non-toxic version. And our goal is to close that doorway so that it cannot go into the ear, but leave the doorway open to go into the bacteria.
And then it seems like it worked.
There are still many steps that we can do to improve on that first generation before it is more ready for more other preclinical models and obviously eventually to patient use. The first step is always the hardest, so the second and third steps would be easier. So I hope that this would be ready within the next 5 to 10 years. I think the long-term goal is obviously to recreate a new class of antibiotics, aminoglycoside antibiotics, that would have no damage to any patients to their ear at all. They can just worry about getting rid of the infection, not worry about getting hearing loss.
And so if we can just replace that drug and keep it working potently but get rid of the hearing loss, that would be rewarding.